Mr. Chairman, and thank you, Mr. Secretary and General Schwartz. Many of us were stunned about the plan that you have to remove 8 of the C-130s from the Fort Worth Joint Base, from the 136th Airlift Wing, and to move those to Great Falls, Montana. That 136th has been crucial for the evacuation of victims of hurricanes and storms. In fact, all 5 governors of states on the Gulf Coast sent a letter to the president strongly asking that this relocation not occur. They said, losing the C-130s takes away a powerful airlift asset for saving the lives of Gulf Coast state citizens. Now, these are governors who've relied heavily on the 136th Airlift Wing in response to Hurricanes Gustav and Ike in 2008, Dean in 2007, and Hurricanes Katrina, Rita, and Wilma in 2005. In fact, the 136th has flown 423 sorties in response to storms, have safely evacuated over 3,000 victims, and delivered 939 tons of emergency aid. So there will be no guard C-130s on the entire Gulf Coast, which we know is one of the key places where hurricanes certainly hit, but we also have Tornado Alley in that area. In addition to that, General Schwartz, the Air Force has requested a $3 million earmark in FY13 for operations and maintenance to fund a temporary shelter for these C-130s in Montana. The Air Force has also requested $20 million in military construction funding for fiscal year 2014 for conversion of facilities from F-15 to C-130s. The DOD said in the request that the C-130s cannot fit inside the current hangar and perform maintenance, thus negatively impacting the C-130 mission. Until this proposed project is completed, the lack of a fuel cell control facility will also cause maintenance delays, forcing fuel cell work to be done on the ramp in harsh winter conditions. You responded, General Schwartz, to Congresswoman Kay Granger in a March 6th hearing that the Air Force has not yet completed all the work on this. I'm hoping you're going to say today that it is still being assessed and possibly for a rethinking of this kind of a transfer when these have been so vital to an area that is really the area of the country that has the most disasters and emergency needs, and this 136th is specifically trained to be the immediate response for these governors that use it, so use the wing. So my question is, are you reconsidering, and if not, why not?
Short answer is yes, we are. In fact, part of the Council of Governors proposal was an adjustment to our original recommendation. So as the Secretary indicated, it certainly is under consideration. I would only offer this context, though. While it is true that there are no Air National Guard C-130s in the Gulf region,
there are
numerous other C-130s,
yes,
both active duty and reserve, and that the FY12 National Defense Authorization Act enables the active duty now to provide a support to civil authority, much like the interstate compacts that exist between the states for Title 32 application of the Air National Guard. Nonetheless, the short answer to your question is yes, it certainly is under consideration, and for some of the reasons you mentioned and others as well.
Did you have a comment, Mr. Secretary?
Just wanted to reinforce that, yes, we are looking at this in the context of the Council of Governors proposal, but to reiterate, as we go forward and the military becomes stronger, we need to think about the most efficient use of our armed forces across components. And we know this has been an issue for the Guard, but in the Gulf region, we have active Guard reserve airlift. We have about 100 either C-130-like or helicopter-like capabilities that are available. And we have done the analysis on support to hurricanes and tropical storms on the Gulf Coast, and the numbers show that the active duty actually ends up flying in support of the states and the governors and the federal disaster support plans has flown fully half or more of those kinds of missions. So we are, as a total Air Force, available to support the governor's needs when there is a natural disaster.
Well, let me just say that I do think that the Guard is the immediate call. That is, all of the training with the governors is Guard, and they have been very successful and immediate. They give the immediate response. And secondly, as the former chairman and ranking member with my colleagues in Senator Feinstein of the Military Construction Committee, I know that when you have facilities and then you talk about moving and constructing all new facilities, really, because they're not prepared for it, and then you have the operations and maintenance increase, I just would hope you'd look at the efficiencies there, where you've got the support at the Joint Base, also a part of the policies of the Department of Defense to have joint bases that are more efficient. It's a Navy lead base, but Air Force has both fighter wings, as you know, a fighter wing as well as the C-130. So I'm just saying, it's hard for me to see an efficiency argument here when if it ain't broke, don't fix it sort of attitude. So I'm hoping you will reconsider for whatever reasons that are the right reasons and keep this very vital asset where it's performed so well. Thank you very much. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
I thank you, Senator Feinstein.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman. If I may, gentlemen,